So remember the mother-in-law who charged at her daughter-in-law after a disagreement about what her grandson ate? Well, we have some answers to your burning questions and a few updates. For anyone new, the situation started when the mother-in-law thought her grandson only had an orange for lunch. Like, she completely missed the fact that he also had a hamburger. And what turned out as just like this dispute turned into a big argument, which took a shocking turn, and the mother-in-law actually physically charged at her daughter-in-law. This left the couple shaken, not knowing what to do, and they reached out to us for help. You guys had questions, and so did we. First of all, did the mother-in-law ever apologize? Yes. 3 days later, she sent a short text. It literally said, "Hi, sorry, hope the baby is doing well." That's it. Not exactly heartfelt. I mean, it was more like a weak attempt to just move forward rather than take accountability, but that is what she got. Next, is the mother-in-law going through menopause? Honestly, that's what this couple thought too. Like, that was one of their first thoughts. But while it's tempting to blame hormones to both the husband and daughter-in-law, it feels deeper to them. Finally, could it be dementia? Many of you raised this in the comments, like you were so concerned of early signs of dementia, especially since she claimed to have blacked out during this whole incident and she can't even remember the charging at all. We'll get into that in a minute. So after 3 weeks of going no contact, they scheduled a phone call with their in-laws, and they had two goals. They wanted to go over just issues that had been coming up, boiling up for about a year, plus they wanted to talk about the charging incident. Here's how it went. The father-in-law spoke the majority of the time. The call lasted for about a half an hour, so he talked probably 27 minutes out of the whole thing. He offered up what felt like a desperate, like, surface level apology. "Whatever we have done to offend you, I'm sorry." So it was more like a plea to keep the family together. I mean, the daughter-in-law said, "I felt so sorry for him. He was so desperate." But it was like a plea to keep the family together rather than taking real accountability. When the mother-in-law finally spoke, it was for about a minute. That's it. She was shocked about their claim that she charged at her. She said, "I don't remember that at all. I don't even remember getting angry." Her exact words were, "I must have blacked out." And then she did apologize. She said, "If I did that, I'm sorry." So it felt more like an excuse than a genuine acknowledgement. Their conversation just kind of ended. It just puttered out after that. During the call, though, the couple realized, okay, the family's trend to sweep conflict under the rug is alive and well, and that's what they're trying to do. But here's the thing. While the apologies were not satisfying in the least, they were likely the best that this family is capable of. The daughter-in-law doesn't believe that they're intentionally avoiding accountability. She truly believes that they lack the emotional tools to reflect, like, at a deeper level. To her, it feels like her in-laws desperately just want to fix things to keep the family together rather than having a willingness to actually change. While this is frustrating, it's also a little sad. So now what? Well, this couple has decided to set firm boundaries to keep everyone safe and protect their peace. So going forward, at least in the beginning, they're going to do monthly visits. So 1 day a month, they're going to have monthly visits. It's supervised. So they're never going to be alone with a grandchild. Any rude comments or behaviors are going to be swiftly corrected. Now, I want to say, these boundaries are not to punish the mother-in-law at all. They're just trying to create an environment where the family feels like they can interact safely and respectfully. The daughter-in-law is fully aware that some people might cut off ties entirely after something like this. She recognizes that her in-laws love their grandchild deeply, and they love their son, and in their own way, they care for her too. And to her, that's worth working on. Now, back to the dementia question. After the podcast episode, the daughter-in-law suggested to her husband, "You really got to encourage your mom to see a counselor or get a medical checkup, something." While he is open to this, he's not sure if the mother-in-law or, like, his mom will follow through on it, but he wants you to know, "I have heard you and I will keep an eye on it." What's more likely, both the husband and daughter-in-law said the emotional rigidity resonated with them a lot. Her mother-in-law is, like, black and white, and she always has to be right. And this honestly feels like what was at the heart of the incident to begin with. And through that lens, she is starting to see better ways that she can navigate this dynamic with her mother-in-law. While this story might feel unsatisfying because there's no big, like, dramatic resolution, it's a reminder that sometimes moving forward doesn't mean you fix everything. Sometimes it means setting boundaries accepting what people are capable of, and doing what you can to keep your family safe and healthy. To everyone who took the time to leave your advice and insights in the comments, she wants to thank you with her whole heart. She wishes that she could respond to the comments, but she wants to keep her anonymity, but she wants you to know that you have helped her family start to heal and move forward, and they're taking everything that you said to heart. We will keep you posted as updates keep coming in, but for now, this family is doing the best they can, and sometimes that's enough.